In this lab, we're going to focus on NFS. And basically, we had that one in data communication. So it's going to be very easy here to understand NFS. So what we do here, we install an NFS server, and then we verify that we can connect to NFS server. So to do that on a Windows server, so first of all, check your IP configuration, because very important. ncpa.cpl, check your IP. I have two IP addresses here. One of them is local, that doesn't have IP. Probably I should enable. Details. Seems that doesn't appear. Okay, I'm gonna check from here. Oh, IPv4 is disabled. Why is disabled? 10.1. So that's my IPv4. That's connected also to the internet. You don't need for this tab to be connected to the internet, but it seems that IPv4 connection is down here. Okay. That's your internet connection. That's from previous lab, you know. I didn't touch anything. This one also is 192.168.10.1. So probably if you look at here under settings, you have one NAT connection and the other one is a custom VNet, VMNet 19. Under Windows 10, we have only one network adapter, VMNet 19. And let's look at the IP address also here, ncpa.cpl. So here is 192.168.10.100. Okay, perfect. So 10.1 and 10.100. We're gonna continue this part. So we come back to Windows Server and add role and features. Next role features here, server selection. So under file storage, if you look at the file storage and open this one, there is one item here, server for NFS. You will enable this and add feature. So then you click on next and next to install this service. So then when you, well, once you install this service, I'm just waiting, installation succeed on this server, close it. Then you have file service. Then here you have also NFS settings, NFS group, right? So what we are looking here, you go under share, and then you create a new share here. So select on, you see that you can also create SMB. We had also under Ubuntu. So we're gonna create NFS. So it has two options, advanced and quick. We're gonna select quick. Is server select by, so here we should select the folder that we want to share. So I'm gonna create maybe folder here. Let's see that. For example, here under C, I'm gonna create a folder share, for example, and then I select this one, select this folder. So that means that share folder is the path that I wanna share. So the share name is going to be share, local share pass, and that's a remote pass. Okay, that's good so far. So good. So then next, so which protocol you want to enable? So you'll select your browse number. If you enable no authentication, then enable the Kerberos. Also, enable on map user, allow on map user access by user ID and group ID. So this is like, this is the way that you ask for username password. If you click on this one, allow anonymous access, that means that without username password, so the user can access. Kerberos is a protocol like a ticketing system that we have on the Windows, and you give a ticket for once, and then once the user log in to the Windows operating system, then the ticket is going to be expired. So here under a specify permission, so you add, so host. So basically this is what it is. You're saying that which host is allowed to reach to your NFS server. For example, this IP address 192.168.10.100, I can put it here. I can say, okay, 192.168.10.100 is allowed. Or you can say all machines. If you don't wanna put any restrictions, you can say all machines. So then share permission, you can say, okay, read write access. Okay, so that means that 1000 now is allowed to read and write. Next. So this is permissions that we have here under here, like owner has a full control, administrator also has a full control. If you want to customize it, then you're able also to customize this part. But just leave it as default and then click on next. And then create. And then close. So you see that now your NFS section or NFS partition here is enabled. So to verify it, you can go under Windows, your Windows. First of all, make sure that under control panel, because there is like a feature for NFS, also we did it through the data communication lab, the other lab that I show you for NFS. I'll show you that there is like a NFS service for NFS here. So you should enable now on for a client and administrative tools. So then this one, it will enable NFS for you. So you have two options here. You can go, remember that we had CMD, you can go and write here, type here ANO for verifying their NFS. We had that one also. So also you can go write, the easiest one is this way, that you can go here and go through the computer and map drive network. And then you can put the server IP address here, 192.168. Was it 10.1, right? 10.1 and then slash share. That's the folder. I guess that's the folder. Yeah, that's the share folder. You see that? Also have it. And I put that one as a Z drive. So this one, anonymous, also if you type anonymous, oh, you probably should enable that one. It's not enabled now. But this GUI is enabled, so then you can share this one. So how we can verify, look in the Windows, if you create a file here, text file, for example, Hamid, and then put that one from Windows 10. And then if you come back here to your C drive, where is my C drive, then under share, see that file is here. So your NFS is working properly. So you can verify it also on Linux operating system, but one of them is enough. We had previously Linux, so you don't, if you do it here under Windows operating system is good enough. But in the document of the lab, I put also how to verify Linux operating system as well. And that's the lab for NFS server.